Retro Rob plays everything.
Hey, Rob here, and it's time for GPD Win versus GPD Pocket. Now, I get asked a lot, which one should I buy? And I just don't answer, honestly. There's been a big silent thud for me. And the reason for that is I don't really want to steer you the wrong way, because what is the right device for me may not be the right device for you. So the idea of this is to basically come up with a guide covering a bunch of the features of both so that you get an idea of what the differences are and what their functions are and see which one's right for you. And then I'll tell you which my favorite is, but really that should be irrelevant to you. My favorite should not matter. It should be really about which one do you want. So that's the point of this video. I'm going to get started and I'm going to get the heck off the green screen so that we don't have a whole bunch of artifacts like that. So Bogart, which one do you like better? Do you like the GPD Win? Oop. Okay, looking at them both, you can see that there's a definite size difference. The screen on the Win is 5.5 inches running 1280 by 720. And the GPD Pocket over here, that guy has a 7-inch 1920 by 1080 resolution screen. Both of them have really good color. I mean, they're both very bright, very vibrant. Not that you really see it in this because of the lighting conditions where I'm recording, but they both look really good. I mean, the touchscreen on them, both of them, I haven't had any problems with. There are some things, though. I have a much harder time reading this screen than I do this screen. And that, to me, is a really big deal because I'm over 40 and my eyes are going. So that might be something you want to keep in mind when you're choosing between the two. However, that said, remember that the smaller screen means this one will very easily fit in a pocket. And the GPD Pocket, well, you're going to need some cargo pants for that. I have put them in my cargo pants, by the way, and it was successful. But this fits a lot better, and it's a lot easier to travel with. Let's look at the deck a minute. Looking at the GPD Win, you'll of course notice that it has a built-in Xbox-like controller. Note that if I press down on these do not have the L1, R1 buttons. So there is no ability to press down and run, say, in first-person shooters. That said, there are people who have hacked them to do that. I'm thinking about doing that with this one, but it isn't a stock thing. Also, notice the chiclet keyboard. It is very small. It's kind of slow to type on, unless you've ever typed on a BlackBerry. I suppose you'd probably be used to it. But it's not my favorite keyboard at all. It's difficult to type on. But that said, it has a built-in controller, and you don't need to take an extra controller with you. This, of course, does have a full keyboard. It's a little bit small, but it is quite easy to type on. I will tell you that playing video games on it is kind of difficult because of the juxtaposition of the WASD keys. I know, it looks okay, but when you're actually playing it, you have to skew your hand off a little bit to the left to play first-person shooters. Now, what I do with this one is I've got a controller that is wireless that I hook up to this, a Bluetooth controller that I use, and I'll show you that later. It's the Nest 30 Pro. I've got another video about that and I'll link it in here, but I use the Nest 30 Pro, which is a really pretty darn good controller, and even works on first-person shooters pretty well, which I demonstrate during the video, so it's fine. But here's the thing, if you're a gamer, you gotta carry an extra piece of equipment around for this. For this one, everything's built in for most gaming. Again, I don't like doing first-person shooters with it at all, but I sure do a lot of dual-stick shooters with it. All right, let's go take a look at the ports and the general construction. All right, if you look at the right side of the GPD Pocket, you're going to notice that it has USB-C. That's for power, and it's got a micro HDMI. And then it has headphone jacks and a USB 3 port. That's it. That's all this thing has on it. Also, notice that it's made out of aluminum. This is a completely aluminum system, you know, obviously, except for the screen. So it's made out of some pretty solid stuff. It feels really good. It has great construction value. Very nice. I'm going to also mention, I'll mention cooling later, but I'm going to mention that the construction quality is just, it's so high, it's kind of hard to believe that this is a smaller company doing it, because it's very close to Apple quality, and I got a Mac right next to here, and the quality's right up there as far as the actual frame construction on it. The GPD Win, which, you know, I've commented this in the past, I don't think it is as well made as like the GPD XD even. That said, it's not a cheap thing. I mean, definitely even Asus has made cheaper stuff. HP's definitely made cheaper stuff with the Stream series and all those light ones. So I don't want you to be afraid that this thing's gonna fall apart. It doesn't feel like it's gonna fall apart, but you definitely have to be a little bit more gentle with it than you would with the GPD Pocket. That said, it's a specialist device. I mean, this is a gaming device that is for people that are just really into this kind of mobile device. I'm going to note on the back. We've got USB-C. Okay, USB-C. We've got HDMI mini, not micro. You've got a micro SD card. Now notice, there is no micro SD card on the other one. There's no space for a micro SD card on this one. There is, however, on this guy, so that's something to keep in mind as far as storage goes. You're not going to be able to do it with the other one. There's a USB 3. Most people now are using the USB 3 for storage on the GPD Win just because it's a much faster storage method. I don't use it because I use the USB out when I'm recording videos, but generally I would be using a USB 3 hard drive in it. And I'm sure that's how most GPD Pocket users go. And of course there is the audio out, and then, you know, everything else is blank, everything's on one side. So this actually has one more port. If you absolutely feel you need a micro SD port, guess what, this is your only choice, because that one you're gonna have to pop in a USB to get it. Okay, let's talk about RAM, ROMs, performance, and all that other stuff. GPD Win has 4 gigs of built-in system RAM. The GPD Pocket has 8 gigs. I will tell you that performance-wise, I don't see a huge jump. I'm going to give you some performance numbers in a little bit, and we'll go over them. But it doesn't seem to make a huge difference, although I'm sure in some games and some applications it will make a huge difference. 64 built-in gigs of storage right here. Storage on this guy, 128 gigs, but remember you have an SD card on this guy and no SD card capability on this one. That said, generally you should just use USB 3 for that function. I mentioned HDMI output. Both have Bluetooth, which is fine for connecting extra controllers, mice, those kinds of things. I almost always use the touch screen instead of a mouse on these, unless I'm playing a game, in which case I plug it into USB. I absolutely feel the lag on Bluetooth. I don't feel it on controllers so much, but I definitely feel it on Bluetooth mice. So I don't know what's up with that. Jericho, which one do you like better, the GPD Win or the GPD Pocket? No choice at all? Okay, well, you're still in trouble for eating the cat food, dog. Processor-wise, these both run the same Intel Cherry Trail X7 Z8750 quad-core 1.6 GHz processor. Now, note something. That is if you have a current GPD Win. If you have an older model like I have, well, this one actually runs an older 8700 series processor. So you might want to keep that in mind when you're shopping for them. You might want to get the 8750. Alright, next we're going to talk a little bit about heat dissipation, because these handle it in completely different ways. Now this one has an internal built-in fan, actually they both do. It's completely controlled by the main port. However, The GPD Win has something kind of unusual on it. If you look on the bottom, it actually has a switch right here, and that switch controls your fan. So it has a low, medium, and high setting, and you set that yourself. So that's something to note, and this is something to monitor too, because you need to keep an eye on this. If you have this off and you're constantly overheating the device, you're going to shorten the length, well, shorten the life of this device. So I keep mine on high all the time, but this is really something to note. This is manually controlled. This one's automatic. Physically, they both get kind of warm if they're really pressed, but they're both pretty reasonable as far as heat goes. This has a 6700 milliamp battery, and this one has a 7000 milliamp battery. Now, times. I'm always asked, hey, how long does it last? And I honestly, that is a rough question. Both of these can last in excess of 10 hours if you're just browsing and doing minimal stuff. You can also probably get a couple, well, you can definitely get a couple and possibly even three movies out of these things if you are being reasonable with it. But gaming wise, I have noticed that this one, it tends to not last as long. Now that's anecdotal, but it does seem like the battery goes dead more often on this. It's not a big deal for me, but I want you to note it. And honestly, they're better playing games when they're plugged in. Although you can do it on a battery, you know, it's not impossible or anything, and it doesn't really hurt it too much in performance. But just note that battery life's a little bit shorter, it seems, on this one than it is on the Win. Sound. They both have pretty loud sound. I mean, it doesn't really help to play the sound here. I know a lot of people just turn it up and show you, oh, look at the sound. It doesn't matter because the sound's going to be coming through your speakers. So I'm going to tell you this. It has moderately okay mid-range sound. It's fairly clear. This is both of them. They're both fairly loud, but they don't have a lot of bass. It doesn't sound like a serious stereo system in any way, shape, or form. And it basically sounds like your average tablet, just a little bit louder. Now it's time for our digital drag race with the GPD Win versus the GPD Pocket. I'm going to tell you right now that this is a surprise upset. these numbers I've run dozens of times. I already know who's going to win generally when I go into the digital drag race section because I've run the test. I do these several times because, number one, I want to throw out any erroneous data when I'm making averages. And by the way, on the averages, the Pocket would win. But I also do the test basically the same way. I power it up from a dead cold start, and I run the test once, and then I run it again to get a full test. And that's how I did it this time, the same way I did it always. But this time, the GPD Pocket got his butt kicked by about 100 points by the GPD Win. So the GPD Win ran a number that I never got out of it in testing. 2400 is a number I just never got out of this thing in any of my tests. So maybe it just knew it was on camera and didn't want to be embarrassed. But I have to stand by the numbers. I mean, I'm not going to fake the numbers for you. In the digital drag race, I got to give it to the GPD Win by 100 points, even though in the averages it lost by about 50 points. But it doesn't matter. What matters is when you're on camera and it wins. So, which device is for you? Well, which one is for you really depends a lot on how you're planning to use it. If you don't have a lot of space, if you know that you're going to be taking the device to a lot of places,
where you can't have bulk. In other words, you're just going to have you in your pocket, no backpack, no anything. And you're just going to be playing games. The GPD Win is going to be a good choice for you. And the reason is, number one, it's less expensive. Number two, it has some external storage to it, which is, that's kind of a big thing. I mean, it's kind of mitigated by the fact that this thing has more internal storage than this one. But the fact is that it is a much more mobile device. If you're going to play games on the GPD Pocket, you're going to need all these things. That said, if you are looking for a more stable device or a more general computing device, I think you're going to find out that the GPD Pocket is probably more for you. So if you're going to be doing typing, you absolutely don't want to type on this thing. There is no way you want to do it. It's kind of a pain in the butt. So this is probably going to be your choice. Also, if you're carrying around a backpack all the time, this makes a little bit better device. If you're older, this makes a little bit better device because it's got a larger screen than this one. So this one, way better for general computing plus gaming. This one, I would say, is the better choice if you're on the go a lot and want to do gaming. Also, I have found that the battery does seem to last a little bit longer on this one over the Pocket. So that's it. 100% dependent on what you want to do with it. Okay, so which one's my favorite? Well, I'm going to tell you, it's the GPD Pocket. And the reason for it is GPD learned a whole lot of lessons from the GPD Win, and they applied them to the Pocket. Number one, this construction is, it's really second to none. And I'm just talking about the physical construction of the device. It's a very tough little device. It can probably take a pretty decent beating, although I've been babying it quite a bit. I like the fact that I don't have to think about the heating system. I'm not worried about the fans at all. And I know there's been fan problems with this, and it seems to be corrected now on the GPD Win. But, you know, this is all automated. I don't really have to think about it. The bigger screen's better for me because I'm older, and I've got, you know, my vision isn't the best anymore. So this screen really appeals to me. And I like the fact that it has a keyboard, and I can use it for multiple purposes. So it's a big winner for me. But, again, you know, please pay attention to that last section, because if all you're doing is gaming and you got yourself some good eyes, you can save $100 and buy this one. You're going to be perfectly happy with it. All right. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please do me a favor. Give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Also, note that I've got links down to Gearbest below. If you are planning on buying GPD, hey, do me a favor and click through there and check out what they have to offer.
Retro Rob's Gaming Videos.